Myself, Ganesh Beaglav, working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this session of conduction, we will see rate of heat conduction through cylinder. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to derive heat conduction through cylindrical coordinate system. In previous sessions, we have derived heat conduction through plane wall. Now, in the cylindrical coordinate system, I will be drawing here cylinder. This is the isometric sketch. In this cylinder, the hollow cylinder, small elemental area is selected, this one. It has dA area. The cylinder has internal radius RI, outer radius RO, internal temperature TI, and surrounding temperature is TO. Surrounding in the sense surface temperature, surrounding temperature TO. Now, as we know, the thermal resistance for this hollow cylinder could be represented by applying electrical analogy. So here this is the inner temperature, this is the outer temperature, the rate of heat conduction is denoted by Q. At the end, we will be writing here the thermal resistance for the cylinder. As we have the equation dou square t by dou r square plus 1 by r dou t by dou r is equal to 0. This is general heat conduction equation in radial direction without heat generation under steady state condition. This could be written as dou by dou r of r dou t by dou r is equal to 0. If I take the integration, then this can be written as r dou t by dou r is equal to c1. Now here it will become dt. This can be simplified to dt by dr is equal to c1 by r. Now, in terms of temperatures, this can be reduced to dt is equal to c1 by r into dr. Now, if I integrate on both sides, this can be written as t is equal to c1 ln r plus c2. This is suppose equation number 1. Now here, to find out the constants c1 and c2, I should apply the boundary condition. So boundary conditions are, first boundary condition, at r is equal to ri, t is equal to ti. At radius ri, inner radius, temperature is ti. These are the inner radius and inner temperatures. Second boundary condition, at r is equal to ro, t will be equal to to. Now, using first boundary condition, the equation 1 becomes Ti is equal to C1 ln Ri plus C2. Similarly, I can use equation second, then this will become TO is equal to C1 ln RO plus C2. I can take the difference of this equation 2 and equation 3. Then if I subtract equation 3.2 from 2, then I can write here TI minus TO is equal to C1 ln RI minus C1 ln RO. This C2 will get cancelled. Now, so TI minus TO is equal to C1 ln RI by RO. C1 can be written as TI minus TO by ln RI by RO. This is the constant C1. This is the constant C1. Now, I can use the relation of C1 in equation number 2. So, this can be written as TI is equal to, instead of C1, I will be substituting the relation TI minus TO by ln RI by RO into RI plus C2. So C2 will become TI minus TO by ln RI by RO into RI. This is the relation for C2. Now we will substitute C1 and C2 in equation number 1. So substituting constant C1 and constant C2 in equation 1. Equation 1 is T is equal to C1 TI minus TO by ln RI by RO into ln R plus TI. This is the C2 now, C2 relation. Plus TI minus TO by ln RI by RO into RI. Here I can take TI on the left hand side. So T minus TI will be equal to, from these two equations, I will be taking common TI minus TO. In the bracket, it will be ln R. Denominator is also same. So, it can be taken as a common ln RI RO minus RI. ln is forgotten. So this is ln RI. Now, so further simplification is there. T minus TI divided by TI minus TO will be equal to ln R by RI by ln RI by RO. This is known as temperature distribution equation. Where TI, TO, RI, RO can be measured easily, whereas at any radius, unknown temperature T can be calculated. Okay, so that is the use of temperature distribution equation. So next part is, that is part B, to find out rate of heat conduction through hollow cylinder denoted by Q. Now think over the equation which will be required for deriving this. Yes, it is Fourier's law which has Q is equal to minus Ka dT by dr. Now because in the radial direction we are finding the equation for the conductive rate of heat transfer. Since since we have d by dr, this equation, since we have d by dr of r dt by dr is equal to 0. If I take integration then I can write dt by dr is equal to C1 and that r in the denominator, C1 by r. So here this dt by dr relation can be substituted in Fourier's law of heat conduction. So Q will become equal to minus Ka into C1 by r. So what is C1? Just now we got the C1. So Q is equal to minus K into A. C1 is Ti minus To by Ln Ri by RO into 1 by R. Now here the area is minus K pi dl, surface area. So 2 pi r L, this is the surface area. Ti minus To by Ln Ri by RO into 1 by R. This R will get cancelled. We will be having the equation minus K Ti minus To by into 2 pi K L. This K I can remove it so that I can write 2 pi K L Ln Ri by RO, which can be written as Ti minus To divided by Ln RO by Ri divided by 2 pi KL. So this is the rate of heat transfer through the plane wall where the thermal resistance for the hollow cylinder is equal to Ln RO by Ri divided by 2 pi KL. So in this way you can solve the numericals. For further study you can refer Fundamentals of Heat and Mass Transfer by Inkruper-Devitt. Thank you.